Grand Theft Auto Online has been out for more than 7 years, and still, they're bringing out some content for us to make more money. However, there are two businesses that everyone still seems to recommend and still seems to use to make money solo in Grand Theft Auto Online. These, of course, are going to be the CEO Crates and the CEO Import Export. Let's put them head to head and see which one is really going to make you more money. The results might actually surprise you. What's going on, everybody? This is Fantagar with 100% Gaming, and welcome back to my channel. If you haven't already, make sure to subscribe, hit that comment, hit that like button, as it really helps out a small channel like mine. Now, as I did say earlier, this is a solo guide, so this is recommended for players who want to just play by themselves. You know, if you want to do the CEO crates with other players, sometimes you have to do the mission where you get 3 crates. It really speeds that process up. However, it's really only good for the CEO, and no one else makes any substantial money at all. There are plenty of other ways to make money in groups, such as doing the heists. The import-export method is pretty good because we're doing missions such as targeted data and diamond shopping. Now, these give 30 grand to every player that is in the CEO when the mission finishes. So it can be good, but still, it's just not as good as completing a heist with your mates. Start collecting crates. We're going to need 2 things. One is the Maze Bank West apartment. That costs $1 million. Next, we have to buy 2 large warehouses. These both hold 111 crates each, but they can be a little bit expensive. The cheapest is $1.9 million, the next is $2.135 million. I recommend getting the cheaper ones. They all do the same thing, it's just different locations on the map. Now, at first, these do seem expensive, but you will be making your money back. The next thing you're going to have to buy is the nightclub. The cheapest one is the one at Elysian Island and is $1 million. Go and pick that up. Afterwards, we have to buy ourselves a terabyte, and finally we need to buy ourselves an Oppressor Mark II. The reason we need a terabyte is so we can start the resourcing from the warehouse with the terabyte, with the computer there, and the Oppressor Mark II just makes doing the missions so much quicker. Now, I understand that this is a little bit pricey. Adding it all up, it's come to $9,435,000. That's close to $10 million in Grand Theft Auto Online. But if you can afford this, it is a great way to start making some money. Alright, now let's see how much money we have to spend to maximize our earnings with import-export. First, we're going to need to buy ourselves a office, grab the Maze Bank West again. Now, a little different, we're going to have to buy ourselves a vehicle warehouse. I recommend the one at La Mesa, it's the cheapest and it's a good location. Now, we're going to need to buy a nightclub again, grab the Elysian Island one for $1 million. After that, we are going to have to buy ourselves the terabyte, but this time we're going to need the drone station because we want to be doing some of the client jobs, and finally, after that, the Oppressor Mark II. Now, with buying everything we need for the import-export, we're actually saving a little bit of money over buying everything required for the CEO crates. It comes to a total of $7,715,000, so we're saving about $2 million. That's basically because we only have to buy one vehicle warehouse instead of 2 CEO crate warehouses. Now we know how much it costs to set up both the crate and the import-export businesses, we're going to take a look at how much money we can make within the hour. After we've done that, what I'm going to do is I'm going to see how long it takes us to fill 2 warehouses with 111 crates, see how long that takes, see how much we earn there, and then, with the same amount of time, see how much money we make with import-export. I'm sure you guys know how to run crates, I'm sure you've done it before. You start the mission, pick up the crates, run it to your warehouse. You're going to have a 5-minute timer until you can do that warehouse again. So you're going to go over to the other one and start sourcing the crates there. Now after you've done that for about an hour, you're going to be able to sell both warehouses. Now here's a look at the profit and loss that I was able to make. When selling both of the warehouses with 16 crates inside, I was able to make $240,000 from each, meaning together I got $480,000. Now we do have to pay money to fill up these warehouses. Each warehouse required me to do 6 missions, and in total it cost me $92,000 for each warehouse, a total of $184,000. We've got to subtract that from the money we made from selling them. Now we need to subtract the $184,000 from the $480,000. And we end up with a total of $296,000, just short of $300,000 per hour. Now $300,000 for an hour's worth of playing is really quite a good amount of money, but if you know what you're doing with import-export, you take a shit all over that and you can make up to $500,000 per hour. Let's see how we do that now. So it is important to know that when we're doing import-export, we're not only sourcing and selling cards, we're doing a bunch of missions in between. These are hostile takeovers, diamond shopping, targeted data, and headhunter. So there's a bunch of missions that we do all in rotation to make heaps of money. So as I was saying, in an hour we can complete 2 hostile takeovers, 2 diamond shopping, 2 targeted datas, 5 headhunter missions, and finally 3 export missions. And this brings us to our expenses. When we sell a car, we do have to take $20,000 from our profits there. So we sold 3 cars at $60,000. So from selling the 3 cars, we get $240,000. Now we add it all together and we get a huge, absolutely massive $512,000. That is insane for just an hour's work, which is obviously so much more than what we're getting doing CEO crates. Well, let's take a look at how long it takes us to actually fill up large warehouses, see how much money we're going to make from that, take that time and put it into doing import-export. So it took me around 7 hours to be able to fill up 2 warehouses with 111 crates. 7 hours is quite a long time, but it is worth the grind. Every time you add more crates to your warehouse, they actually add up to a larger amount. So say if you have 1 crate in your warehouse, that crate is worth 10 grand. If you have 111 crates in your warehouse, each crate is then worth $20,000. So you really do want to have as many crates as you can in your warehouse before you sell them. This is the main reason why we want to buy a large warehouse instead of a medium or small, because you make more money in the long run. Now when we finally get around to selling our warehouses, as you can see, one large warehouse of 111 crates sells for $2,220,000. Now doing this method, we do sell 2, so that's going to come up as $4,440,000 in sales. That's pretty nice. Now unfortunately, we do have to buy the crates. I highly recommend you buy 3 crates at a time. Yeah, sometimes you have to go pick up 3 crates at the same location 3 times. It's a bit annoying, but it is so much quicker. When you buy 3 crates, it does cost you $18,000. Divide that by 3, that's $6,000 per crate. We do have to buy 111 crates, so in total, that's $666,000. We have to times that by 2, and we get $1,332,000 off our profits. Now looking at our profits, we need to take what we've made from the sales, take away the crates purchased, and we end up with $3,108,000. Guys, for me, this took me 7 hours to collect all of the crates. And after I'd sold all of my stock, I made $444,000. Now, this seems like a good amount, but as we saw from import-export, which shits all over this, we made $500,000 in just 1 hour. That's 1 hour's work, and you've already made more money per hour than you have worrying about these crates. It's just not worth it. Now, it's not fair to say. Now there's an elephant in the room that I need to address, and that is what happens if you sell in a populated lobby. You can actually get a 1% bonus for every other person that's not in your organization in the lobby. You can have a total of 30 players, so that means you can have 29 rival players in the same lobby as you. And I've gone ahead and done a little bit of math. Don't worry about it too much, I've put it up on the screen. But basically, if you sell both large warehouses with 29 other players in the lobby, you make $5,727,000, or just a little bit over. There's an extra $600 there for you. So we're going to take our sales minus the crates purchased, and we're going to end with $4,395,000. And we're going to be making an absolutely fucking massive $627,000. Dollary dues. I actually can't believe how much money we make doing it like this. high risk, high reward. Alright, and real quick, we're going to take a look at how much money we can actually make with the import-export systems in 7 hours. It's a really simple calculation. All we're doing is taking the $512,000 and we're timesing it by 7. This leaves us with a huge $3,587,000. Now, I know we've spoken about a whole lot and you might be a little bit confused and unsure which to pick. So I'm going to show you a quick little recap of what we discussed. Now, if you're only selling 16 crates at a time, that's basically two small warehouses, you do make $296,000 in a solo session. That means no one is in that session to give you that 1% bonus. It's decent money, but it's not a whole lot. On the right side here, we have what we make every hour with import-export. We make $512,000 at least in a solo session. If we are in a solo session and we sell two large warehouses, we are going to make $3,100,000. Divide that by 7 hours, we're going to make $444,000 every hour. That's still great, but it's still not as good as our import-export. With import-export, we made a little over $3.5 million, times that by 7 hours, and again, we've made $512,000 an hour. Now, if we're playing in a public lobby, this is where it all changes. Import-export still makes the same amount of money as there is no player bonus attached to it. You still make the $512,000 every single hour. But now you're just playing with other players and there is the added risk. However, with two large warehouses, both with 111 crates inside them, you make a huge $4.395 million. Every single hour, you're going to make a massive, absolutely fucking huge $627,000. That is huge, and that's because you get the 1% bonus for every other player in the session. So if you have 29 other players in the session, you get a 29% bonus to the money on top of what you would have already earned. Now, what's really important to address here is this isn't using any other businesses in the game. There's no MC businesses at play. There's no bunker. This is just straight doing these businesses. This is a hell of a lot of money for anyone in Grand Theft Auto Online. Now, there is a massive risk with selling your cargo with other players in the session. They can come along, they can blow it up, and that is literally all of your money gone. That is 7 hours of your life completely gone. You've lost everything from that time you have spent. You can quit the session and you will lose a little bit of the crates, but not all of them. As long as the vehicle that you were driving has not yet blown up. If it has, this will not work. Also, you can activate Ghost Organization, which will keep you hidden for a little bit of time. But with all of that said, with all the oppressors and hydras and deluxes driving around, it's still a huge risk. Now, it's a little bit funny that the whole purpose of this video was to figure out which business actually offers more money and finally close down the argument. However, as it turns out, it actually depends if you want to play in a solo session or if you want to play in an open lobby. That ball is in your hands.